In this lesson, we will see how to use checkboxes to allow users to specify the value of a Boolean attribute. The first thing we'll do is to change our product definition, and we will add a new attribute which will indicate if a product is imported or not. And you'll notice that due to the name that we gave to the attribute, the platform infers that the data type of the isImported attribute should be a Boolean value. A Boolean data type can only store two values. It's either true or false. Before we continue, let me just make sure that this attribute is created in the database, and I'll publish for that. Okay, can close this now, and let's go into the product detail so that we can edit this new attribute here for a product, here in the product detail. And what I will do is to create a space for a new attribute. So there, I will add a new label. And here the text is imported. And I will add a checkbox input, this one here. A checkbox can only store two values, as we said before. It's either checked or not checked. So this means that the variable that we need to bind this checkbox to needs to be of Boolean data type. And we will bind this variable again to the form record, and we will choose here the new attribute we created, the isImported. Okay, so we can now edit this attribute. Let's go back here into the products. And I also want to show here the new attribute here in the table record. So let me drag and drop the attribute. And you'll notice that the platform renders the attribute here in the table records as a check image. And what I want to do next is to create a new filter here to hide the products that are imported. And to do this, again, we will use the checkbox input. So let me add here the checkbox input. And we will need to bind this checkbox to a variable. Again, since we are not using this input inside a form, we will need to create a local variable. And we will call it hideImported. And again, the platform inferred from the name of the variable that this is of Boolean data type, which is correct. We can now bind it to the checkbox, and can do this again by dragging and dropping the variable on top of the checkbox widget. And let's add here a label, hide imported products. And now we will need to use this variable in the aggregate we have in the preparation. So again, go back in here to the preparation, open the aggregate, and let's add a new filter. Let me just show here first the attribute on the aggregate. There, and at this time, all the products that we have are set with the isImported to false, because this is a new attribute. We haven't set any of these products as imported. We will do that once we publish the application. But now let's create the filter here, and the filter will test when the user ticks the checkbox in the filter. So when this hide imported is ticked, we only want to show the non-imported product. And the same is to say that when this is not ticked, when the value of the variable is false, then we will show all the products here. And the condition that we want to write here is either we want to show all the products, meaning that the value of the variable is false, or we want to show only the ones that are not imported, meaning that the product is imported is equal to false. Okay, so that's our condition. We're all set. Let's publish and test our application. Okay, so first of all, let's set a couple of these products as important. Let's say, for instance, that this MacBook Air is imported. Let's save, and there you have it. The information is stored in the database. Let's say that this Dell screen is also imported there. And let's test our filter. Let's hide the imported products. And there you have it. The products that were imported are hidden from the list. And that's it.